Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. My name is Monika and in this video we are going to create this nice and bright animation of a gradient in Illustrator, of course. So let's start. I have already prepared the file with all the artwork in it and we're going to discuss how to arrange this and build this using Illustrator and GIFStudio extension. So there is this kind of shadow which has a pattern applied. And as you have seen in that animated GIF, this pattern moves in the shape. So that actually happened by accident. And there are two different methods to build this, and I'm going to tell you what to do when you want it to not move. So on top of it, there is this gradient shape, and then there is a text object, which is a point text. That's important. And then we have this shape of the speech bubble. So these are all prepared, and since GIFStudio animates based on artboards, the first thing we need to do is set up the artboards as we need them. So in order to make this a looping animation, what we need to do is create one more step when preparing this, and then later we will leave out that step. Now, let's first set up the artboards. I have designed this in the size I want to export it because I can't scale anything. And I have already set up the artboard in the size I wanted to clip that artwork. So I'm going to the artboard tool and then I can create new artboards using the plus button, and let's have the artboards panel open so we can count them. So now Illustrator creates all these artboards, and also the order should not change. So they should be in a row, and some space between them is a nice thing to have, and that's okay like this. If you don't like the way Illustrator sets them up for you, you can select them all and shuffle them using this button. And there, of course, you need to set up the number of columns the same number as your number of artboards, so they are all in a row, which is important, and then set up the spacing as you need it. But I'm going to cancel that. So the next thing we are going to do is move this artwork. So I'm going to first see that it fits the artboard exactly so that I can move it precisely, and like this. And we need just do yet another step, because this gradient, it's just one gradient now. And we need some more shapes, and also I need to enlarge this slightly so that it fills my actual speech bubble. And then we need some copies, because the animation is not actually the gradient stops moving around, but gradient shapes. So what we're going to do is duplicate this by pressing Alt and Shift and moving it up. And yet another time, like so. So we have three of them and they just move down. So let's select them and group them, but there already is a group. So what we're going to do in the layers panel is just grouping them like so by moving the shapes into the existing group. So that's it. And now we are going to select all the artwork and copy it by pressing Alt and Shift again and moving it to the side like so. Let's check this. Yeah, it fits the artboard because some of the things should not move and some should. So only the rectangles should move. And the next thing is we should set up the layers. So we should set up a layer stack here. I need some layers because I need a mask on this and I cannot use the clipping mask. So I cannot use the object-based clipping mask, that is. So what I would need to do is take my speech bubble shape and then this shape and then create this clipping mask down here. But that would not work with the method I'm going to use to animate this. So we need to set up a different kind of clipping mask and that is layer-based and therefore we need the layers. So let's set up some layers here. And I need three layers. I put the text object in the first layer and the other text object as well. So let's move it up here. And then we need those two paths in the middle layer and those two groups as well, like so. And then in the bottom layer, we need those patterns. And now what we need to do is create the animation. And I'm just doing it by just moving these gradients. So I need to move them precisely. So let's go into outline view and move in a little, zoom in here. And then let's just take it. And I'm going to move this corner to there. That's all. So the smart guides are on. I'm going to grab that group by this corner and just move it down and there it snaps and that's all. So that's all we need to do. And now we can create the animation. So let's start by selecting these two groups and then go to Object, Blend, Make. And there are too many, so let's just double click the blend tool and then go to specified steps. And we need 9 steps. Let's check it out like so. That's it. And the same goes for all the other things. So these two paths, I'm going to move them to the top and then let's select them both. Make the next blend. I'm going to use the shortcut, which is Command Alt and B, and on Windows it's Control Alt and B, of course, and then double click the blend tool again, specified steps, and again 9 steps. And let's do the same with the text objects, like so, and again we need 9 steps, which is this, and do this again with those patterns. And for the patterns, I told you that the patterns should not move. And as of now, they are just the shapes with a pattern in it. And when I now do the blend, then the pattern inside will move. This will create this flicker. If you like that, fine. If you don't like it, what you need to do is create a symbol. So that would have to be done before copying those objects to the other artboard. So before you do that, make a symbol out of that shape and then blend the two symbols. Now I have only got the shapes, so I will get the flickering. So let's blend them and double click this. Go to specified steps and set that to 9. Okay. So now what we still need to do is the masking. And for that, I'm going to select the blended speech bubbles. And this blend needs to be expanded. So let's go to Blend, Expand. And this is now a group. I'm going to ungroup that. I have all the paths. And now we are going to make a compound path. Go to Object, Compound Path, Make, or use the shortcut. And now I can use this compound path to create a different kind of clipping mask, which is the layer-based clipping mask. So I have the layer, which is highlighted. I don't need any selection, so let's just take that away. It doesn't matter, but it's not needed. So I'm just going to highlight that layer and click on this button inside. And now we have the clipped speech bubble like so. And the next thing we need to do is delete that last artboard, because that would be a duplicate in the animation and the animation would look like it stops there. So we don't want that. And we are just going to the artboard panel and then select this last artboard and delete it like so. So the artwork is still there, but it won't get exported. So let's go to Window, Extensions, GIFStudio now. And let's just get all these artboards. And then I'm going to select them all by pressing Shift and clicking on them. Yet another one. Input the duration. I'm going to set 0.2 seconds and return. And then let's just take a look at it. This looks kind of nice. So let's just export it like so. And we're going to save it. And that's it. We have created the animation. So that's how you can use blends to create easy animations with Illustrator and GIFStudio. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.